It's better to say you tried and you failed than to get to the end of your life and have regrets and say, I wish I would have. Do it. Now.
Hi, this is Joyce Littell. You know what? The best part of my day is dropping some jewels with my man, Julien Virgin. What's up, Julien?
This is Mike Jordan.
Hey, this is Chandra.
This is your girl, Desi T.
I'm Larisha Harris.
I'm Eric Freeman.
What's up, it's Sky, and you know I love.
And I love. And best believe.
Whenever I have a chance, I'm always somewhere dropping jewels.
I'm dropping jewels.
Dropping jewels.
Dropping jewels.
Dropping them jewels with Julien Virgin.
With Julien Virgin.
Julien Virgin.
Julien Virgin.
With Julien Virgin.
Princesses, my seatmate Tonya is now officially dropping jewels with Julien Virgin. Tonya, not how you doing, but how you living?
I'm living good. I'm living wonderful. I'm blessed.
Explain your wonderful. Explain your blessings.
Well, in 3 days, I'll be 50 years old, and I'm going to Montego Bay to turn up. I'm living, I'm loving, I'm laughing. I'm good.
You deserve.
I do, and I look good doing it. So, hey.
Absolutely. We're sitting here right now on our Delta flight about to take off to Montego Bay. I don't know about you. This is the first time I've ever flown first class. You do this often? What's up?
Well, I grew up flying first class. My dad used to work for the airlines. So I never flew coach until, maybe college. So I always did fly first class. Not a whole lot as an adult because I didn't want to pay. to keep it totally honest.
That's 1,000% real. I read something maybe a couple years ago. It was like, you should treat yourself to this because it makes you think about things from a different perspective.
I do believe that life experience and exposure is important, definitely important, especially, I think, too, at a younger age, you know, to let children know that there is something else out there other than their neighborhood, their block, their street, their city, you know what I mean? So exposure is very, very important. And then you're going to spend the money on something, you know, as an adult. So if you plan right and you move yourself around, you know, allow yourself to get accustomed to luxury. Why not?
Why not? Again, ladies and gentlemen, sitting here with Tonya, 3 days ahead of her 50th birthday. We are on the way to Montego Bay. Tonya, you talked about these life experiences. You're coming up on 50. I'm not asking for your entire life story, but as you sit back and reflect on this new year coming up and this milestone birthday, what are some things in your life that you're like, dang, I'm happy that I chose that?
I don't have any regrets. I can say that. I don't have any regrets. If I did think that there was something I could change, I think I would have lived a little bit more freely without fear, you know? And I think some of those fears probably came from upbringing, parents always trying to keep you safe and saying, you know, don't do this because this could happen, or don't do that because that could happen, you know? So it took some years of like peeling back those layers, almost like an onion, peeling back those layers of fear. So I think that there are certain things at certain points I would have done sooner if I didn't have those layers to peel back. And I think that people now, you should definitely push and encourage young people to live out loud. You know, that's one thing that a lot of people that are around my age don't like about, like, the millennials, because they think that they should live a certain way because that's the way that their generation was raised up. But one thing that I do really admire is the fact that younger people live without those fears. I really do admire that. And then that they look at life from a totally different perspective, that you can do rather than what if it doesn't work. But what if it does?
That's exactly how I live my life. It's a no fear mindset. Now, Tonya, I'm 28. You talking about younger people, millennials. I guess I fall into that demo. You were looking at your 28-year-old self right now and were able to tell her something, what would you say?
That's a good question. Well, I probably would have pursued a singing career. Yeah. If I didn't have certain fears implanted, I would have done that. Yeah. Even if I had to do, like you hear some celebrities say, oh, I was homeless and I had to sleep in a car and I had to do all of that. Even if that happened, I think that I should have went for it. I kind of went to college, got a real job like they told me to. And then I always did hair. But again, they said I was too smart to be just a beautician. So, like I said, I went to college and got a real job. And after 13 years in corporate America, I got tired of that shit. So I went and I got a cosmetology license. I've been a salon owner for 14 years. You know, I've been a cosmetologist for 19 years and I've built a great life, six-figure, you know, business. But going back to your original question, 28-year-old self, I probably would have gone towards the singing career.
You got to shout out the salon now.
Oh, A Woman's Worth Hair Studio, Tampa, Florida.
Much respect to you, at least pursuing something that you so love in cosmetology and hair and beauty. On a personal level, right now I am still fighting getting back and getting a regular job because this is my passion. I love storytelling. I love traveling. I love talking to people. I love just engaging with people just on a real level. And sometimes they tell you should go work for like that radio station or that television station. And, you know, after 3 years of being independent and outside of corporate America, opportunities are still presenting themselves. But I'm sure you realize as a business owner, after you start getting it on your own, it's hard for somebody else to cap on how much your hour is worth. Have you felt that way before?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Even the thought, I think if I had a corporate job, a regular job, as soon as they tell me, you only get 15 minutes for lunch, I'll probably be like, oh, dog, no, it ain't gonna work. I go to lunch when I want to. I work when I want to. You know, it's very hard to transition back to that. And one thing about it is that when you have a passion that you can monetize, you have no limit as far as how much money you can make. If you work a corporate job, they tell you how much money they're gonna give you and their boundaries there. You get your raises if they say. When you work for yourself, you could just decide that you're going to go hard and you can go out there and get it.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, Julien Virgin sitting down with Miss Tonya Bostick 3 days ahead of her 50th birthday here in first class on the way to Montego Bay. Before we take off and we enjoy this flight and we get on with the festivities, Tonya, I want your final thoughts. Something on your mind, your body, your spiritual soul that you want to leave me here with today.
Live life without fear. Go for it. It's better to say you tried and you failed than to get to the end of your life and have regrets and say, I wish I would have. Do it. Now.
Tonya, I appreciate you taking some time out to drop some jewels with Julien Virgin. Welcome back to Dropping Jewels with Julien Virgin. The song you're hearing behind us is called Live It Up Rhythm by FS Green. This is a remix of Ja Rule. Tonya and I met while sitting next to each other in first class on our flight to Montego Bay, Jamaica. We initially connected just off the strength of her being curious about my recorder. So it was dope, and throughout the duration of our flight, man, she dropped a ton of jewels, this one in particular.
Live life without fear. Go for it. It's better to say you tried and you failed than to get to the end of your life and have regrets and say, I wish I would have. Do it. Now.
After we got through interviewing, you know, in this format, you know, again, we sat there on our plane and just talked to each other throughout the whole time. And she said something that I had to write down that just stuck with me. Tonya said, I don't do shit that stresses me out. I repeat, I don't do shit that stresses me out. And, you know, a lot of times we grew up and she even told me this. She said, my dad would always tell me that sometimes you got to do what you don't like to do in order to get to where you're trying to go, which is fair. And we've heard that a lot. But Tonya, after working a corporate job and now being her own boss, just straight up is like, I don't do shit that stresses me out. And I felt that on a spiritual level. Again, throughout our time, we ate, we drank, we laughed, and we talked about life, family, her career, and her nonprofit, Rich Auntie. So I encourage you to support a hustler and follow Tonya's journey on Instagram at Tonya B Hair. And next time you're in Tampa Bay, go ahead and check out A Woman's Worth Hair Studio. If you enjoyed that, Jewel, and would like to hear and view more dope content, check me out on julienvirgin.com and smash that subscribe button. Until the next time, I appreciate you for dropping jewels with Julien Virgin.